Hello students, have you ever placed your hand on your heart region and felt the heart sounds? These heart sounds that are generated from the heartbeat are the indications of the proper functioning of the heart. We would also have observed that doctors usually use a stethoscope to check the heartbeat by listening to the heart sounds. Let us see how these heart sounds are generated and how the functioning of heart usually occurs. So let us learn about cardiac cycle. Cardiac cycle refers to the sequence of events that occur from one heartbeat to the next. During cardiac cycle, the heart contracts and relaxes so as to pump the blood to different parts of the body and collect back into the heart. The cardiac cycle includes three main events, which are the atrial systole, the ventricular systole, and the atrioventricular diastole. Let us see what happens during atrial systole. The atrial systole begins with the release of the cardiac impulses or the contraction impulses from the sinoatrial node that is located in the right atrium near the opening of the superior vena cava. The sinoatrial node is also called as the pacemaker of the heart since it is responsible for setting the rhythm of the heart. The cardiac impulses that are released from the sinoatrial node are distributed to all parts of the atria. As a result, the atria contracts. When the atria contracts, the pressure in the atria builds up. This pressure allows the atrioventricular valves, the bicuspid valve and the tricuspid valve, to open. As the valves open, the blood present in the atria is pushed into the ventricles. But here we have to note that even before the atrioventricular valves open, 80% of the atrial blood flows into ventricles since the atrioventricular septum is leaky. The opening of the atrioventricular valves allows only the 20% of the remaining blood to flow into the ventricles. This is how the atrial systole occurs. Once the blood is flowing into the ventricles, along with the blood, the cardiac impulses also moves from the sinoatrial node to the atrioventricular node and it passes down the ventricles through bundle of His and it is distributed to the Purkinje fibers. From the Purkinje fibers, the cardiac impulses are received by the ventricles and ventricles start contracting. This marks the beginning of the ventricular systole. When the ventricles start contracting, two major things happen. One is a forced closure of the atrioventricular valves. The forced closure or the shutdown of the atrioventricular valves generates the first heart sound, LUBB lub. Also, the semilunar valves that are guarding the aorta will open. This allows the pushing of the blood from the ventricles into the aorta. The amount of blood pushed into the aorta per one contraction of ventricle is called as stroke volume. Each stroke volume is about 70 ml of blood. Once the blood is pushed out of the ventricles now start relaxing. This marks the ventricular diastole. As the ventricles start relaxing, the semilunar valves which are open during ventricular contraction now starts closing. The closure of the semilunar valves during ventricular diastole records the second heart sound, DUBB dub. This is how the heart sounds are generated, one during ventricular systole and the second during ventricular diastole. Once the ventricular diastole is finished, the atrial systole again begins. This is how the cardiac cycle repeats itself so as to pump the blood to different parts of the body and collect back into the heart again. This is how cardiac cycle can be explained during which the heart sounds lub and dub are generated. Before concluding, let us also learn about the cardiac output. Cardiac output explains the amount of blood pumped out of the heart per each minute. The cardiac output in humans can be calculated as the product of the heart rate and the stroke volume. The heart rate in humans is usually 72 beats per minute and the stroke volume is 70 ml. So, the product of 72 beats per minute and 70 ml will approximately give you 5 liters. So, it is 5 liters of blood that is pumped out of the heart per each minute. This is how the cardiac output can be explained. Make your concepts stronger and stay ahead in your learning journey. Join me and other Cybit experts on the Tutor app for daily free concept classes. Download the app now.